Po, welcome back to the project. Jira here with another reaction video. This one should be exciting because we're dabbling into movies. This is a marathon episode 28, by the way, and I won't waste any time. We're gonna do a different format now, try something new and just dive right into the stuff. So let's start watching a movie, right? We have several scenes. It's not a full movie, just the clips on several tabs, and we want to get through of these so that we can get to things that probably won't be so easily copyrighted. So I'm going to switch over to display and show you what I intend on doing. So first we have here is an opening scene from Baby Driver opening scene. Well, I'm going to click back. I don't know where it goes, but that's what the movie originally was. Then we're going to go across and hop over to these two tabs, in which case they're both from, well, what's it called? Suicide Squad? Right, and that will pretty much, oh, and then wrap up that movie and hop over to Venom Eating Carnage. So four tabs of clips, you could say, and I don't know, I just wanted to watch it. So I might as well create something out of it. And yeah, I think I'm just going to toss aside a lot of that convoluted stuff that's not really necessary. I mean, for sure it can be in the backdrop at the back of my mind, but it's not really necessary, is it? Says 89 million views. I don't know why. Let's see how long it is. If it's a short, maybe you can watch it. No, it's 5 minutes, and I don't want to watch something that's 5 minutes long. Oh, how quickly to go from fears to dropping a bank to fearing for the last second starts driving. So it looks like a comedy. What I'm gonna do is just gonna hop over backwards and see what was here. Quicksilver. Okay, we can react to this. So before we start that, let's start the new scene. We were at intermission at first and went to display. And now we're going to move over to backdrop. Okay. So this should be interesting. 3, 2, we'll just expand the whole thing. Alright. Let's go. Quicksilver. When a bank helps you make mute Spotify. Actually, just stop it right there in his tracks. Let's go. This is one of my favorite scenes, by the way. I want to turn up the volume. I wonder if I can do a full screen. Pause it before we go full screen so that doesn't end up lagging. This made me really like this song, by the way. It's a goated scene right here. And the song too, so resonant. Some of them want to be abused. So sick, dude. I'm watching this for like the fourth time. By fourth time, I mean once on YouTube and like two other times, like we actually watched it on television many years ago. Oh, fish. Yo, organic chemistry. R chain. Well, I can't remember anything anymore. Nitriles, DNA, F equals G, M1, M2, over. Yo, this is taking me back. Shit. Nice touch with the whole moonwalk, right? It just takes you back. It's like, this is definitely in the era, because the era the movie takes place, it's a 2016 movie, but of course in the time era of the movie. This is talking about like the 80s and something like that. We're talking disco and Michael Jackson. Okay, one thing. Hey, what's up? Something I read about the comments in a previous watch. Quicksilver has to eat in order to replenish all the calories that he's taking to expend so they can move at this speed in, you know, the blink of an eye or in seconds, really, of the explosion. So the details of him taking the pizza and eating all the pizza and then drinking the can of Coke or whatever, that's all very realistic, apparently. That's actually what he's doing in order to replenish his energy sources. That's very interesting. Oh, something's up, man. Goldfish. Pizza.
Wow.
Okay, that's sick. Pretty sick, right? All right. So that's the scene we watched. Let's collapse this and go to the comments, like we gotta do. For every one of these four, we gotta go to comments. All right, let's go. So this was sheer brilliance. Ants Canada. Yo. Favorite. Hello there. Fun observations, right? So this is a great one. So this is where I learned about the eating food. He notices the blaze starting on the left. Special power, super speed. Able to hear the sound blast before anyone else. Unfortunately, too slow for only one X-Men. Okay. 3 1-second run from one location to another, burning 1,000 calories, given its speed and weight. This guy's working out the physics. 4. Assume he ate an entire box of Twinkies, 20 before he arrives. 1 remaining. Each one 150. 2,850. He drinks the soda, try and gain more energy, speed. He eats nearly a whole pizza, 2,500. Whole steam puts him at 5,500 calories, which is enough for the whole day for any regular person and beyond to make you overweight. But for what he's doing, we assume he's burning calories not only from speed, from the heat as well. Causing the entire area to heat up. Huge surge in energy all around. By the end of the scene, assume he's burned up all his calories and he's hungry again. Love you and see Quicksilver's personality through the scene. He's laid back but putting effort to save people and pets. And pets, that's important. Love how efficient he is. Makes you wonder all the time he spent testing out his power. I'd imagine as a kid, he could conduct thousands of experiments to see how things react in hyperspeed all in a split second. Yeah, he had all the time in the world since he lives in super speed. And so he has to fight boredom. All right. Okay, I know this is why we're all here. And this guy loves animals. Also, he takes the time to check every nook and cranny to make sure he didn't miss anyone. Such a nice detail. Yeah. So what do you think we should, you know, I feel like this is a good place to, he's laid back, he's putting effort to, yeah. Who have been panicking, both to him and even Evan Peters. Okay. Personality through the scene. Love the moonwalk touch. Touch as well. Puts you in perspective of the times. 80s disco. Disco. MJ. Something like that, right? Times of the scene. The movie. Detail. Touch as well. Don't need to put perspective for that. Okay, reply. And that's that. So very easy. coffee. That's one down, boys. Let's go. Let's go. So that's one video. And just gonna copy paste. It's cool. No problems there. All right, let's head on to the next reaction. We can probably close this now, but we'll wait for several and then we'll just mass close at least three of them. And that should be fun. Okay. So let's make this bigger. This is the story of El Diablo. So for those of you who watched Suicide Squad, of course I've heard that it was not a good movie. It was a pretty shit movie. And I can sort of concur based off the scenes that I saw. But there were certain scenes that were really good, right? There, it's just, you know, the finale and some the plot and just didn't make a whole lot of sense. But there were some good scenes because of the actors themselves. Just, it was great acting from several of the actors, including Will Smith, Margot Robbie, and whoever played El Diablo. I don't know his name, but unfortunately. I believe he was also starring in Breaking Bad. He's a very familiar face. So here we go. The story of El Diablo.
See, I was born with the devil's gift.
I just realized something. I probably shouldn't go full screen. It might be showing too much. It probably helps to keep it minimized. These are full movie scenes, right? These are lasting 6 minutes. Hell, that Quicksilver thing might have gotten me copyrighted. Unfortunately, we probably won't be able to watch with me, but on Patreon, you can probably see the whole thing in full, in better detail. Okay. Yeah. I'll probably think of something to edit it out. I don't know.
One was feeding.
Yeah, we can do that. We can add it. We can apply a filter over for sure. Okay. Wow, look at the development here, though. This is something I want to highlight, because you see him on... This is like... You know, you look back at the previous household and the attire, and not only this attire, they're a matured couple for sure. The way they're dressing, you know, the way they... The dynamic between them, right? Watch.
This is our home!
Even in English, too. The rings, the composure... If you look at El Diablo, look at him with a shirt on that's like really more like more suitable for like a dad. He actually looks more like a dad here.
Hey.
And then the household is just the atmosphere is different as well. It's kind of like at in the middle of night after everyone's come back from work, right? And the kids are sleeping, whereas that earlier one is all the mother is in like booty shorts and he's in a tank top. And the kids are like really young, and then there's like bright sunlight shining in what seems to be a bit more of a more decrepit. I don't know. It's not decrepit. It's very warm, a warm place, a warm house, but it's just you get a sense that they're just scraping by, right? This is not the case anymore. Like that scene, this really stuck out to me how well they made the scene. Contrast from the other house here.
This is our home.
The development of their relationship.
Put that back when you fell.
As a family. It's him because he has a daughter, and that guy sees it on the far right. I love picking out the body gestures and behavior that the actor's trying to copy. Something one of the comments mentioned, Harley Quinn apparently later on in the movie has a scene where it's a reference to what she just said right there. She ends up trying to press the normal setting on the dryer, or chooses not to, something along those lines.
Outside, you're amazing. Yeah, you are.
Yeah, you are. Okay, sure. Yeah, I'm gonna get fucked up.
We don't want you here.
You get to the part in that binder saying I was sleeping with you. Yeah.
Interesting.
I never been with a witch before. What's that like? Apparently that's why the creatures chase him all the time, because the witch is scared of him. The only woman I ever cared about.
So there's a reason for him to be here too.
Trapped inside that monster. If I don't stop the witch, it's over. Everything is over. Everything.
Sounds very dramatic. Right.
You're free to go.
You're free to go. Look how without hesitation, some of them leave and some of them stay. Telling of each character. And you kept this from him. But you kept it for him still. At least you didn't throw it away. Was that a slap coming? An incoming slap, or?
I'm gonna get you there. And you're gonna end this. I'm gonna carry your ass if I have to. This shit is gonna be like a chapter in the Bible. Everybody's.
Like at the Grammys, right?
Gonna know what we did. My daughter is gonna know that her daddy is not a piece of shit.
That's right, you gotta stand up for your woman, right? Okay, I'll stop. No, I've always felt really bad for Will because I've been in the same situation. Well, it's not exactly the same, obviously. I was not a Grammy winner and I never slapped anyone like that. But like I've been quite manipulated and pushed around, who took advantage of my inherently very poor and dysfunctional and disturbing upbringing. So I know what Will went through, right, with the whole Jaden. I mean, not Jaden. What's her name? I don't even want to remember her name. Just the sight of her screams, egotistical, arrogant, easily offended, explosive, manipulative. But the point is, you know, I'm not laughing at Will, you know, in a mean-spirited way. It's more like just some lighthearted jokes, you know. I know that there was a time those jokes would have affected me, right? So I'm just being, yeah. Stand-up guy, right? It's a stand-up guy just like in this movie. If you ever notice something, we'll always play stand-up guys anyways. Wants to be a family man.
He's gonna know that her daddy is not a piece of shit.
Cool. The making of Suicide Squad. All right, so let's minimize this. Let's go down here. Let's see what we're going to post away. I like how this group of villains, especially Boomerang, that kill and rob without blinking, seem to be stunned that Diablo murdered his own family, showing that they are still human inside regardless of the choices they've made. I like how Boomerang's worried about the kids. Criminals have standards too, right? Sopranos. Digger Harkness. I like how Will Smith's like, I've never been a witch before. Bad Boys 3 as a kid one. Harley Quinzel. The normalist. Yeah, this is a comment that I was talking about. So she knows. Oh, look, it's a Chinese comment. Sui Zhong. 水中, I don't know what that means. Honestly, I can't read the first three and the last two. Oh, hmm. Oh, well, I don't know enough to decipher the full phrase. Anyways, sorry. I'm just like, oh, I recognize some. All right. Diablo, Harley, Deadshot, basically the main characters. His story was the best and made the most sense why he wanted to die. Naturally. Started crying when Deadshot said what he said. But not wanting his daughter to believe he's shit. Oh, personal. Oh! I felt that. Wish my daddy believed in that. Fuck. That's fucking relatable, man. Fucking relatable. Wow, that just came so natural. I just immediately wanted to say that. I just want to make sure that he didn't respond, so. Yeah, these are really relatable. Same here, my father left me 2 years after my mother cheated on him, had a kid with my brother's father. Uncle. No? Oh, okay. 2 years my dad put up with that. I knew one day he would have enough. He did, left my mother. Now I see my dad once every other weekend. Oi, fuck. It's not how it's supposed to be, man. Don't load. Alright. Yeah, that's fucking relatable. The pug life chose me. Oh. The whole bar scene, honestly, the best part of the whole movie. With a lot of emotions, with a good balance of humor in it. Yeah, my daughter's gonna know her dad. I'll be a shit. It's real deep. I can find that scene like a baby. Yeah. Own that shit. Dumbest line in any movie ever, though. Nah, there were worse lines. Okay. Old channel for a young stupid fool. Why would you say that about yourself? Hmm? I've done that before. I used to have a character named Me Dumbo. It was on Maple Story. It's like those channels. It's like the channel of like the YouTube channel. It's like the channel of a man who. Oh, dedicated it for those without fathers. It's like when I found out there was a YouTube channel. By a man who dedicated it for those without fathers. Creating lessons. Video lessons for things, for topics, dads would have, I don't know, taught their children. Had they been there for whatever reason, I forgot the name, but I dissociated, but it's out there. Yeah. What's out there? Hold on, let's proofread this. This is a run-on sentence. Hits like when I found out about a YouTube channel. Found out when I learned about a YouTube channel dedicated a YouTube channel, a man dedicated for those without fathers, and creating video lessons on topics that otherwise fathers children had they been there. Name that's out there. Super wholesome. Okay, that's it. All right. And that's another comment. That's two down. Good stuff. I didn't expect to post two comments, write up two comments, but it was relatable, right? All right. And also, Suicide Squad. It's a fight. So let's max it out. It's a bit risky, like I said, but we'll see if we can't edit the video to make it, I don't know, blur it out or something. Not only are the graphics looking really, really fake, but I mean, the whole notion of the way things are, like, if it's really, truly a danger, I should hold my mouth.
Family, I ain't gonna lose another one.
Look, take it through.
I got this. Let me show you what I really am.
Oh God, that's so cringeworthy. Those lines. Oh, the dialogue. Yo, you don't just shout something out like that. Not shivers. The action scene aside from Diablo sucks, really. But I mean, look at that look. It's pretty cool. Anytime it has have anything to do with, oh, I can't say that anymore because that thing he just said there was awful. But this is pretty cool though. You got the kids there, the photographs by the side. I don't know Spanish. Spanish. Spinach. I don't know Spanish.
Oh.
takes me back to when your kid's trying to learn how to cuss in a different language, right? In Japanese, Chinese, Spanish, French, you name it.
Rick, in position, stand by.
Oh, holy shit. Oh, he's weakening? What's happening? What happened? What happened? Is that a steam? That just spell it. That reminds me of like when in those shows, like in, especially in anime, where they have to call out the person who just died. Like, no, kind of. No. I'm not saying it doesn't happen in reality sometimes, but come on. Okay, that's a bit much, man. Oh, look at that. That's what we're gonna watch next. Okay. El Diablo deserved a movie of his own. He's powerful enough, had a compelling backstory. For sure, for sure. Yeah, he does. No, he doesn't. Okay, whatever. You can think what you want. Badass Latino Native American god. Latino Native American god villain hero. Never. All you see are Greek gods, Norse gods, and they go and kill him off. Bullshit. He needs some more movie. Potential. It's crazy what they can do with it. Yeah. Literally moral. Literal far god. Who's Megan? It's a demon, not a god, exactly. It's a pump. It's technically. It's not a pump. Imagine killing off the only good thing about the movie. It was intentional. They said we can't allow it to be higher than this threshold. At this point, it becomes not a bad movie, but a mediocre movie. They're like, oh, we gotta keep it below that threshold. I lost one family. Oh, seeing how quickly this line is delivered makes it quite obvious that there wasn't one person in the production team who believed it would be credible. Oh, the memes here. I lost Dom Toretto. Fast and Furious. We need to give props to the soldier that knowingly sacrificed himself in the sewer to set off the bomb. Did he? Part of the real Suicide Squad. Didn't die though. Their fadges. Can't really doubt it. He died. A couple seconds. You can't really doubt it. He died. There's a reason why Diamondite. Oh, interesting. I'm learning something new. It's the reason why dynamite fishing is a thing when saved from a concussion or explosion. All right. I don't think y'all realize how crucial that was to his story arc. That was his happy ending. Getting sad about it isn't quite right. Okay. That I can accept. That was his happy ending. He had made peace with his mortality. He was ready to die alone in a cell. What better way than to just leave right now, protecting the ones he cares about now. In the present, he was given a chance to trade his life for the lives of millions, and you're mad he took it? Interesting perspective. That's why the family footage was shot, were in that shot before it transformed. Not only that, it was only the real moment of triumph of all the metahumans in the squad. He had a lot of potential for epic moments and only got the one. Meanwhile, two of the most normal dead shot I kept taking center stage. That was a victim of bad writing, among other things. Proudly Mexican, this makes me emotional. Not only is the alighted Aztec, the panaco, the skirt. This is how the actual Aztec dancer looks like, for real. I remember this because I used to have like a presentation when I was like maybe in grade 5 downtown. It's a large city downtown. And I went to school. We had one of these presentations where we were learning about the Aztecs and the Mexican culture. And well, Mexico and like the, you know, Mexico. Why does no one give credit to the soldier who sacrificed that to be the bomb, though? Laughing. The comments said, "Lady, you're evil." Okay. Yeah, exactly. Most are giving him credit. Now, what I want to do, so let's see. Great perspective. Thanks for the reminder. Pretty understandable. That the crowd doesn't want to see the only interesting character. Well, one of the only few interesting characters with potential in what was regarded a poor movie, poor film, die off. But I agree, but now I have to agree it was appropriate. Death was appropriate. As well, unfortunate was appropriate. And in fact makes it a happy ending. Am I typing so much? Why am I typing so much? All right, so we're just going to take that and we're going to minimize that and we're just going to copy. Oh, that's the wrong side. We only got one more video left, thank goodness for that. And then we can knock off, you know, pretty much all the tabs here. Well, we're going to get rid of them right now, honestly. Fire frog. Froggy. Right. Great perspective. Okay, so back here, I just want to reread it again. I don't think y'all realize how crucial the star, his happy ending. He made peace. Right? A chance, I took it. Free perspective, thanks for the reminder. Pretty understandable the crowd doesn't want to see one of the only few interesting characters potential was regarded a poor film die off. But I agree the death, while unfortunate, was appropriate, and in fact makes a happy ending. Why am I typing so much? There. Cool. So now, here's the fun part, guys. We're gonna take this, and what we'll do is just hop over to OBS Studio. We're going to switch to display so you can see it for what it is. And we're just going to quickly knock off all three tabs in 3, 2. Oh, don't do that. 1, 2, and 3. Beautiful. Now we maximize that. Awesome. So we go back. This is what it is for me. It's just knocking off tabs for me. That's the most important part. I know that because like I'm more excited to watch Studio Ghibli than I am these films, these flicks here. All right, let's get back here. So we're gonna watch this now. And ooh, so we closed it, and makes sense that we should resize Venom and Carnage. Man, what a I gotta take a screenshot of that. That's what a sick shot. Still recording, very good. So let's get to the reaction in the last film thing we have here. Oh, Tim Henson, here it is. Found the tab, guys. So the top right, this is the tab that we thought was missing. We couldn't find it, so let's move it over with Paul Lefier right here. Yeah, I never heard of this band. You have heard him now. So Three, two, one, let's go. Venom eats Carnage. And to be honest, I don't think I like this scene either, but it's what it is. Do something.
I'm afraid we cannot beat them.
It's a callback to an earlier scene, basically, where Venom told Eddie, if we get a chance to save the world or whatever, can we be called the Lethal Protector? Go for it, buddy. You got this. For the record, if you guys can't tell, I'm so much happier now that I found it. It's been six days since I took a shower. I know I shouldn't be saying that. That's because this project has been driving me AWOL. I've been trying to set up all 500 settings. You know, if this and that, you know, you got a link tree, you got, you know, like 50 different platforms and stuff. I devoted so much time to this project. I did not take care of myself, did not eat properly, did not sleep properly. Business, work, volunteering, I fell to the wayside, the relationships, friend, oh God. Horrible. I'm doing much better now. Thank you very much. I just feel so much better now. I cut my hair, I took a shower, there's still more I gotta do, gotta clean up the house now. Well, clean up the unit that I'm renting out, but I feel so much better now. Feels good. Let's get shit back on the road. Are you tired already? All right, you took a beating already. Okay. Sorry, I'm just gonna pause for a time. This is so cliche, right? Damsel in distress, go and save her. It's just whatever, man. I wouldn't say it is the best movie. I was binging, guys. I told you right now, it's relevant. Actually, I can't believe I just mentioned how much of an improvement I felt now, because that's relevant to why we're watching these movie clips. These movie clips ended up popping up because I was coping hard, heavy copium. I was so tired, just dead beat. I felt so fucking awful that I wasn't taking a shower, that, you know, I wasn't eating right, I wasn't sleeping right. I'm still in a household that has certain people here who are quite abusive. And it just felt so awful. And I was just coping. I just binged on some scenes. I'm like, fuck, if I'm gonna do this, you know, I better record it. So that's why we're doing this. So it comes full circle, guys. It comes full circle. So it's not a great movie, I don't think, but it's something that was entertaining enough for me to click on it because I was just kind of feeling pretty miserable. Obviously, now I'm in better spirits. Now let's just kind of knock this off and make something out of it, I guess. Content. Gotta watch out for copyright, though. Like, does this make any sense, right? Why do you have to come all the way up here just to eat her, right? Just eat her. No. Why should it come? You could have just bitten her head off right on the ground floor. You could have done that. That doesn't make a lot of sense. I heard that when this was in the box office in the theaters, when people saw this, it was in 3D, and people really freaked because like it was awesome freak out, right? It's like it's amazing. There be carnage. Like look at that. Imagine that in 3D with the surround sound speakers in the cinematic theater. Two more, three more. Ooh. Ooh. What a blessing it is to not have a heart, right? Now, part of that I don't really understand, you know, like, why did she do that? Did she do that because, did she know that she would die? Like, I have to ask that myself. Oh, it's the 16 though. This part is pretty cool. I know, right? I'm saying it's so cool. It's just a minor trivial thing. Let's see that plop one more time, man. You're not dead yet? From that fall? You shouldn't even be moving after that. Oh, that's fucking gross, man. Look at that. Look at that shit. Oh, it's like from a horror movie. Straight up. For the record, I really liked Spider-Man when I was growing up as a kid. And I loved Venom and Carnage. And I used to imagine all these like multiple different types of symbiotes like merged together, like different variations of Spider-Man. It's one of those old versions of Spider-Man in cartoons that I used to watch. They had like seven different types of Spider-Man from different dimensions at one point. And I used to imagine Venom, Carnage, both fusing with Spider-Man, and they had an episode like that, I believe. And I imagine some trippy ass stuff. But in real life, you know, I'm pretty sure, just as you would see here, Venom and Carnage would look pretty disgusting. Kind of sad. Particularly this. This is like a fucking tumor cell. It's like a it's cancer right there. I know, guys. I'm not very PC. It's cool.
He did not taste good.
Eating your own son. It's a weird relationship to have. It's more than weird.
No one killed that.
Not anymore.
Fuck this.
Sorry, look at that. The straight up direct. All right, that's cool. Mrs. Chen is venomized. It was funny, but I don't really want to go there. Because it was funny. It was really funny, but I don't want to do more clips. I want this video to end right here. So we're going to post a comment, and then we're ending this, all right? It's too bad. That was a far better clip there. It's funny. That thing was on point. It didn't have all that weird damsel in distress type stuff and weird nonsensical, you know, letting someone live only to be taken down yourself because you wouldn't kill them immediately kind of thing trope. He did not taste good, but his own offspring. Fuck this guy, Bomaniac. He's a straight talker, no less. Which is good. Let there be carnage. For those who didn't get the chance to see on the big screen, just know that a lot of eardrums were broken when he said that, okay? I know, I see on the big screen. For your loud and screaming chick. Venom did a better job in saving in the... I think everyone kind of rips on that movie, I guess. I don't know. I wanted your friendship. Fuck this guy. Also, fuck this guy. There's no in here, guys. We are in sync, maybe. Well, maybe that's... I guess that's what his joke is. We are in sync. We are in symbiotic, okay? Fuck it, Corn Phantom. Best usage of an F-bomb by any PG-13. Mad cringe. His saying mad cringe is pretty cringe. Facts, my boy. You're gonna watch it die. Proceeds to go to the roof where Brock can't see. This movie could be so much better if they took it seriously. Totally messed up. Things were going fast. Should have used Carnage at least two movies. Venom thinks he's a huge badass, but he's just as much of a fucking dork as Eddie. Love them both. Okay. Yeah, this is what I was going to say, you know? It's we are symbiotic or we are in symbiosis. Yeah. Play on in sync. Maybe just play on in sync. I was going to say same. I'm going to say. Thank you, BD. Be to it. Maybe meant in sync. Maybe meant a play. Meant wordplay. For in sync. Sub. I don't know. If I'm being charitable, right? Maybe intentional wordplay. Intentional. This is a reach. This is a reach. Reach. But maybe. All right. Yeah, this is all just silly stuff. We're just fooling around. Honestly, it's such a pointless thing to... What a pointless say. All right, it's going to take this. And... copy this, just acceptance. All right, so that's it. Cool, we're done here. And goodbye. Sorry. Cool, we knocked off as much as we could. Now Sneeko's here waiting to be roasted by penguins and...
Hey, Sneeko, does this outfit look familiar?
Okay. All right. Charlie, chill out a bit, please. Okay. All right. Charlie bit my finger. No, I love penguins. Moist. Charlie stuff. Homeless Jesus. All right. So, for sure. All right, guys. That's it. I think, so let's check both tabs. Make sure that we clear as much as we could. It looks looking pretty good. So we can move over to Studio Gak next. Thank you for tuning in, boys. This is it. And I'll see you guys all in the next round of reactions after I edit the crap out of this stuff. Or fuck the editing, man. I don't want to do the editing. It takes so much time. Let's just leave it as is. And maybe I'll get taken down by copyright. I don't know. Hopefully it's a small enough screen and whatever. Yeah, see you guys in the next one. Peace.